Now, it's unfortunate. If you have an NIV, their translation is unfortunate because they make verse 7 as if it's a whole new command, like he's moving on to another thing. Cast all your cares upon him, they say. That's not accurate. What verse 7 is the procedure for how you allow yourself to be humbled under God's mighty hand. How do you do that? By means of casting all your cares upon him. Our New King James shows that, but the NIV does not. But that's how we do it. So when I'm being brought low, when God's hand is upon me, and life is difficult, life is tough, what do I need to do? Do I need to fight back? Remember what we read a couple chapters ago in chapter 2. When you're reviled, what do? Revile back again? When they yell at you, you yell back at them? You defend yourself? You fight for your rights and all that? No. What you do is you give all your cares to the Lord. You cast all your cares upon him. In fact, let's close by going back to chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 2, just turn a page back. Because this is so important, and it's a fitting conclusion given the discussion we had about the ministry. Because speaking of Jesus, verse 23, and again, he's our example. Chapter 2, verse 23, who when he was reviled, he didn't revile in return. When he suffered, he didn't threaten. He just committed himself to the Lord, to God, basically, to him who judges righteously. He committed himself to his Father. We need to commit ourselves to God. And then look at verse 25. For you were like sheep going astray, but have now returned to the shepherd, as I said, same word for pastor, and overseer, same word as bishop, of your souls. How important it is to recognize that the local pastor, yes, is the overseer of the local church. And I know the church is the people, not the building, but you know who the overseer of your soul is? It's Jesus Christ. It's not anyone who stands up here. Never forget that. Never forget that. He is the shepherd. You know, whoever stands up here, I'm a sheep too. Just like every one of you. He is the one who is the overseer, the shepherd, the pastor, if you will, of our souls. The primary function of a shepherd, when you really think about it, the literal shepherd, the primary function is to make sure the sheep are fed. And that's why the Bible calls the office of pastor as both pastor-teacher. They go together, the pastor-teacher, that's the primary role. And yes, you want to watch out and tend for the sheep and all and keep the wolves away. But the primary thing is to feed, to teach. But as we often pray before our messages, the real teacher is God, his Spirit to us. He is the real shepherd. He is the overseer of your souls. Never forget that. Your relationship with him is what is important, is what matters the most, and is what you need to develop, what you need to seek, what you need to grow in. That's what is so key. And yet, the human instruments that God might place as leadership in the church are held to a high standard. A high biblical standard that we all are very free to evaluate and see how well do they stand up to God's standard. Because if they don't stand up, maybe I'm in the wrong place. Let's pray.